Hey, welcome back to the channel, and welcome to the first episode of my new series, Tutorial Tuesdays, where every Tuesday morning I publish another tech-related tutorial for the average person. And in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to sync up all your audio with your video in DaVinci Resolve. All right, so here we are on the computer. We're in DaVinci Resolve, and the first thing I want to do is jump out and show you the files that I'm working with. Now, I have two sets of files here. I have A-roll. This is all the video that I caught with my Lumix G7 with my camera, and when I caught this video, I caught it with the on-camera audio, even though we're going to be replacing that, and I'll tell you why in just a few seconds here. Going back, we also have an A-roll audio folder. This is all the audio that I caught with my lavalier mic and my Zoom H1N, and this is the audio that I want to use in those clips. So we want to take this audio and replace the audio on those video clips. So all we're going to do is we're going to drag in our audio and video into DaVinci Resolve. This audio video is caught with the on-camera audio, so let's give a little listen to see what it sounds like.
If anybody wanted to see some comparison benchmarking of using the integrated GPU with...
So as you can see, that sounds pretty bad. It's real echoey. I mean, it sounds like on-camera audio. It's terrible. But if we go to the A-roll audio and play a little bit of this,
I'll put a link up here to those videos.
Now you can see that audio sounds much, much better. So we want to take this audio, replace it on those clips. All we're going to do is we're going to come over here, do Control A, select everything, drag it into that A-roll folder. So now we have our video clips and our audio clips in the same folder. And then we're going to right click on the folder and go to Auto Sync Audio. Now there's a few different options. There's two ways to sync the audio. One is based on time code. And if you have a YouTube channel or you're just doing this as a hobby, chances are you're not going to be recording with time code. If you have that option to record the audio and the video with time code, you should do that because that's a much more precise method and it uses a lot less processing on the application because it just syncs up the time. I don't do that. I don't really have a way to do that. So I use Waveform, and this has been rock solid. What this does is it takes that audio that we captured with the on-camera audio in the video clip. This is why we captured that audio, even though we're going to replace it. And it compares that waveform to the waveform of the audio that you capture with that other source, in my case with the Zoom H1N and my lavalier mic. It compares that waveform, and then that first option, it'll just overwrite the audio that's on that clip with the audio we want, completely wiping out the bad audio and doing a really solid sync based on that waveform. The next option on here, based on waveform and append tracks, does the same thing except it keeps both audio tracks. So if there's a situation where you want to use the camera audio source and the audio source from the however else you capture it, you can do that and it'll have both tracks, and then you can just mute and unmute the tracks as you want. I always use the based on waveform. I'm going to select that. It's going to take just a few seconds. What it's doing is it's comparing those waveforms, syncing up the audio, and I'll show you what it sounds like now as soon as this is complete. All right, there we go. It's done. I'm going to take this first clip again, drag that in, and now we can listen to what it sounds like.
What this video is all about, we're going to be using that 2014 Mac Mini that I used in the other videos and an RX 470.
Now you can see how much better that is. It took that good audio, wiped out the bad audio, and basically bound it to that clip. So now even if we drag it onto the timeline, it's pulling it onto the timeline with that audio clip that we replaced. The old audio is gone. We don't have to worry about dragging in the video clip and then dragging in the audio and trying to get them to sync up. It did it all automatically. It is a solid sync. As long as your source audio is reasonably good and it matches the audio that you're syncing up, it does a fantastic job. I've had very, very little problem doing this. Hopefully you found this useful. If you did, hit that thumbs up. If you really liked it and you haven't subscribed yet, please consider doing so. Come see me next Tuesday for my next tutorial video and Sunday for my normal tech videos. Thanks so much.